بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضى. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الناصح الأمين. اللهم صل على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ومن تمسك بسنته إلى يوم الدين. ثم أما بعد، يا عباد الله، قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم. الله سبحانه وتعالى, He says in His noble book, O humanity, fear your Lord. O humanity, have taqwa of your Lord. قال الإمام بن باز رحمه الله تعالى: ومعنى اتقوا ربكم افعلوا أوامره واتركوا نواهيه طلبا لمرضاته وحذرا من عقابه، فكلهم ملزمون بالتقوى الله عز وجل في جميع الأحوال. Imam Allah rahimahullah ta'ala said that in the meaning of and have taqwa of your Lord, then what this means is carry out and fulfill, do those commandments in which He has ordered you with. Carry out those commandments and stay away from the prohibitions. طَلَبًا لِمَرْضَاتِهِ, seeking His pleasure, seeking the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jalla. وَحَذَرًا مِنْ عِقَابِهِ, and beware of His punishment, out of fear of His punishment, being aware of His punishment. فَكُلُّهُمْ, so all of mankind, then it is incumbent upon them that they have taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jal في جميع أحوال, in all situations, in all circumstances. In every situation we have to have fear of Allah Azza wa Jal. No matter the situation, no matter the circumstance, we have to have fear of Allah Azza wa Jal. وقال الله عز وجل, Allah Azza wa Jal, He says, يا أيها الناس, O humanity, يا أيها الناس, يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. O humanity, O mankind, fear your Lord, O mankind, worship your Lord. O mankind, worship your Lord who created you and who created those who came before you, so that perhaps you may have fear of Him, so that perhaps you may be pious unto Him, so that perhaps you may have taqwa. So that perhaps you may have taqwa. فَلَبُدْ مِنْ عِبَادَتِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى بِإِخْلَاصٍ وَصِدْقٍ فِي عِبَادَتِهِ of your عِبَادَ لَهُ. So it is a must that we have sincerity unto Allah Azza wa Jalla in His worship, and that we are truthful in His worship when we worship unto Him, Allah Azza wa Jalla. وَطَاعَةً أَوَامِرِهِ, and that we obey His commands. وَتَرْكْ نَوَاهِيهِ, and that we stay away from His prohibitions. وَقَدْ يُخَصِّصُ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ بِالْأَمْرِ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has singled out the believers with the affair, He has singled out the believers with the command. So I remind you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He addresses all of mankind to have fear of Him. He addresses all of mankind to have taqwa of Him. And He addresses all of mankind to worship Him and Him alone. But Allah Azza wa Jal specifies the believers from amongst mankind to worship Him and Him alone, to have fear of Him and Him alone. to fear Allah Azza wa Jalla and to worship Allah Azza wa Jalla alone. So Allah Azza wa Jalla, He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Allah Ta'ala, He says, O you who believe, fear Allah. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. O you who believe, fear Allah. وَفِي آيَاتٍ كَثِيرَاتٍ. And in many verses, Allah Ta'ala, He specifically addresses the believers to have fear of Allah Azza wa Jal. لِأَنَّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ هُمْ بَعْضُ النَّاسِ. Because the believers, they are a portion of the people. All of the people that have been addressed to have fear of Allah. All of the people that have been addressed to worship Allah and Allah alone. This is wajib upon everybody. This is wajib upon all of mankind. From the men, from the jinn, from the males, from the females, so on and so forth. But specifically, this is incumbent upon those who have submitted themselves unto Allah Azza wa Jalla. This is incumbent specifically upon those who have submitted themselves in Islam. Those who are Muslim, specifically upon the Muslims, then they have to fear Allah Azza wa Jalla. They have to submit themselves to Allah Azza wa Jalla by worshipping Allah and Allah alone. So Allah, He addresses the believers specifically. He addresses the Muslims specifically to have fear of Allah Azza wa Jalla. To have fear of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So the believers, they are specifically commanded to fear Allah by doing that which He has commanded, staying away from that which He has prohibited, by worshipping Him and Him alone. فَالْوَاجِبْ عَلَيْهِمْ أَعْظَمْ لِأَنَّهُمْ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ. So the obligation upon the believers, that it is more tremendous, it is more great. It is a greater obligation. Why? Because they have believed in Allah and in His Messenger. They have believed in Allah and they have believed in His Messenger. Therefore, the obligation upon them is greater. So therefore, we see from another aspect, from another standpoint, that the lifestyle of the believer should not be similar to the lifestyle of the disbeliever. It should not be similar whatsoever. It should not imitate it. Because the believer has submitted himself unto Allah Azza wa Jal. The believer, he believes in Allah Azza wa Jal. The believer, he believes in the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So therefore his life should be molded. It should be shaped. It should be guided by the guidance of Al-Islam. It should be molded, it should be shaped by the Qur'an, by the Sunnah of Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon the fahm, upon the understanding of the Salaf of his Ummah. Because the believers upon guidance. So although all of mankind is addressed, the obligation upon the believer, it is greater because he has submitted himself. Whereas the kafir, he has not submitted himself. The disbeliever has not submitted himself. The disbeliever, he does not believe in Allah Azza wa Jal. He does not believe in the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So his disbelief in Allah, his disbelief in the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is going to have adverse effects on his lifestyle that are going to be clear and evident. So therefore the believer, on the flip side, his belief in Allah, his belief in the Prophet Sallallahu should have clear and evident signs and beneficial traits and effects upon his lifestyle that makes his lifestyle totally different, totally distinct from the lifestyle of the kafir. And this is from what it means to be a Muslim. Is that our lives are shaped by the Qur'an, by the Sunnah, upon the understanding of the Salaf of this Ummah. That we worship Allah and worship Allah alone. That we do that which Allah has commanded us to do. That we stay away from the prohibitions. Imam bin Baz, rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, وَعَلَيْهِمْ أَن يَكْمِلُوا هَذَا الْإِيمَانِ. It is upon them to complete this iman وَأَنْ نَلْتَزِمُوا بِهِ حَتَّى الْمَوْتِ. And it is incumbent upon them that they complete this iman and they hold on to it. They stick to it. They stick to it tenaciously until when? Until a few minutes or 5 minutes, 10 minutes, a year or so, a day or so? No. Until when? Until they die. Until they die. حَتَّى الْمَوْتِ. Until death comes unto them. You see, we should never have in our minds that I accepted Islam a day from the day, so I should be okay then to live the rest of my life as foolish as I want to live it, as haphazardly as I want to live it. And I hope that day I took my shahada way back when in the 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, whatever, will benefit me. Despite whatever I've done after that, despite whatever kufr I've done after that, despite whatever shirkiyat I fell into after that, I hope that day from the days, however many decades ago, will benefit me. We should never have this understanding. This is not the understanding of Ahlul Sunnah. This is not the understanding of the Salaf of this Ummah. This is not the understanding of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. This is not the understanding that Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala sits down and taught us in the Quran. We have to stick to the iman tenaciously until we die. We can't say, I believe the day from the day, so that's it, I'm okay now, that's that. I've done that, now on to the next thing. No, but we have to strive to be upon the guidance, strive to live our lives in accordance to the guidance until we die. This is why the concept of being a Muslim by name is not sufficient. It's not a concept that anyone with an intellect will think will have anything from benefit attached to it. But rather we have to strive to be a Muslim, not just in name, but in practice. As well as in name, but in name and in practice. In reality, truthfully, trying to establish what it means to be a Muslim. Not just that our name is a Muslim name, but that our actions are kuffar, no. But that our names are Muslim names and our actions are actions of the Muslims and our beliefs are beliefs of the Muslims, that all of our person is a representation, all of our person is a manifestation of what it means to be a Muslim. This is not something that is easily attained. This is not something that you will attain in a moment, but this is something that is a life mission. This is why the whole of our life has to be in this effort, trying and striving our best to submit ourselves unto Allah Azza wa Jal, trying and striving our best to be obedient unto Allah Azza wa Jal. And when we come up short, when we fall short, when we make sins unto Allah, that we return unto Allah quickly, with the quickness, with tawbah, repenting unto Allah Azza wa Jal, making tawbah, repenting unto Allah Azza wa Jal. This has to be our life, period. Worshipping Allah and Allah alone. Being obedient unto Allah Ta'ala. Staying away from sin. When we slip up, following that up with tawbah, repentance unto Allah Azza wa Jal. Until we die. This is the way of Ahlul Sunnah. Not believing that our iman will stand and that city can never be affected. This is the concept of the Murji'ah. This is the concept of Ahlul Bid'ah. This is not the concept of Ahlul Sunnah. This is not the concept of Islam. But rather we have to strive to be obedient unto Allah. Strive to worship Allah Azza wa Jal until it comes to us yaqeen. And yaqeen is most. It is the death. As Allah Ta'ala, He commanded the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was the best of mankind. The Prophet ﷺ is the best of mankind. Rather, the Prophet ﷺ is the best of creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the best of creatures. As Allah ta'ala says, wa'bud, worship rabbaka hatta ya'tiyaka al-yaqeen, and worship your Lord until there comes to you al-yaqeen, al-maut. Al-yaqeen, it means maut, it means death. It means death. Al-yaqeen doesn't mean certainty like the Sufiyyah say it means, until you're certain. So now once you're certain, then you don't gotta worship Allah no more, then that's it, you don't worship Allah no more. Because that was the case then, the Prophet ﷺ would have been stopped worshiping Allah Azza wa Jalla. Or does anyone want to say that the Prophet ﷺ wasn't certain about Allah Azza wa Jalla? Does anyone believe that the Prophet ﷺ was not certain about Allah? Does anyone believe that Musa wasn't certain about Allah? Does anyone believe that Ibrahim wasn't certain about Allah? Does anyone believe that Noah wasn't certain about Allah? But rather, we would say that all of the prophets, all of the messengers, they were certain about Allah. They were the most certain from the creation about Allah, and that Muhammad ﷺ was the most certain about Allah Azza wa Jalla. And yet they all worshiped Allah until they died. So we know that certainty and yaqeen don't mean what they think it means, but rather yaqeen it means what? And mode to worship Allah until you die. This is what the Quran teaches us. So therefore we have to what? We have to strive to hold on to this deen of Islam until death comes to us. Not like those who say, yeah, I'm going to accept Islam while I'm in prison. When I get out of prison, then I'm going to do what I want to do. No. You accept Islam and you stay upon the deen of Islam while you're in the prison of this dunya, because the dunya is sijnul mu'min wa jannatul kafir, because this world, it is the prison of the believer and is the jannah for the kafir. So if you're talking about prison this world, okay. But if you mean prison some bars with some seals and that and some brick and mortar, then no one's gonna go for that. But you worship Allah, you be upon the worship of ibadah until you die. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He commands the believers to do. Ya ayyuha alladheena amanu taqullah. O you who believe, fear Allah. O you who say you believe, have fear of Allah Azza wa Jal. Have fear of Allah Azza wa Jal. Ittaqullah haqqa tuqatih. Fear Allah as Allah deserves to be feared. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. And do not die. Do not allow death to come to you. Do not die except that you die as Muslims. هذا أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولجميع المسلمين فاستغفروه فإنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد. يا عباد الله, we have to worship Allah Azza wa Jalla until death comes to us. We have to remain steadfast and patient upon the path until the death it comes. وَعَلَيْكَ فَعَلَيْكَ أَن تَسْتَقِيمَ عَلَى طَاعَتِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ. So you have to become upright upon His obedience. وَتَتَّبِعَ الرَّسُولِ. And you have to follow His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَأَنْتَ مَخْلُوقٌ لِهَذَا. Because you have been created for this. وَكُلُّ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ اسْتَمِعُ. For the Imam bin Baz. وَكُلُّ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ خُلِقَ لَكَ لِتَسْتَعِينٍ بِهِ عَلَى طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ وَتَرْكْ مَعَاصِيهِ. Because everything that is inside of the earth has been created for you in order to help you upon the obedience of Allah and staying away from His disobedience. Everything that is in the earth has been created to help us to be obedient to Allah and to stay away from His disobedience. وَلَمْ يُخْلَقَ. It has not been created لَكُمْ for you, لَكُمْ لِتَسْتَعِينَ بِهِ عَلَى شَهَوَاتِكُمْ. And has not been created for you all in order to what? To help you upon your desires. To help you attain your desires. لتستعين به على شهواتك. To help you upon your desires. كما قال الله تعالى, الله تعالى says, الذي خلق لكم ما في الأرض جميعا. The one who has created for you everything that is inside of the earth. وقال تعالى, وسخر لكم ما في السماوات وما في الأرض جميعا. Allah Ta'ala says, and the one who has subjugated for you that which is inside of the heavens and that which is inside of the earth. And Allah who has subjugated for you all that is in the heavens and all that is in the earth. So that what? So that we may establish the worship of Allah Azza wa Jal. Not that we may be disobedient unto Allah, not that we may utilize them so as to attain our desires and the like, but rather so that they may be aids for us to establish the worship of Allah Azza wa Jal. They may be aids for us to be obedient unto Allah Azza wa Jal. And this is because as the Imam he says, وَلَمْ تُخْلَقْ سُدَى وَلَا عَبَثَى. He says, because you have not been created without purpose, you have not been created, and thus they have not been placed upon you any type of obligations. You have not been created and thus left alone, that you have not been commanded to do certain things and then been prohibited from staying away from other things. Nor have you been created out of just and out of praying for no reason. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى. Allah Ta'ala, he says, أَيَحْسَبُ الْإِنسَانُ أَن يُتْرَكُ سُدَى أَن يُتْرَكَ سُدَى. Do the human beings think that he will be left alone? Do the human beings think that he will be left neglected? That he will not be commanded to do certain things and prohibited from staying away from other things? أَيَظُنُّ أَن يُتْرَكَ سُدَى. Does he think he'll be left alone? مَحْمَلًا مُعَطَّلًا. Left alone, neglected. Not that he placed upon him for obligations. لا بل خلق لأمر عظيم. But rather he has been created for a great affair, for a great issue. وهو عبادة الله. And that issue is the worship of Allah عز وجل وطاعته. And to be obedient unto Allah عز وجل. وقال الله عز وجل منكرا على المشركين. And Allah تعالى says condemning the polytheists. أفحسبتم أنما خلقناكم عبدا وأنكم إلينا لا ترجعون. Allah Ta'ala says, and do you all think that we have created you in just and that you are not returning unto us? أنكر الله عليهم هذا حسبان. Allah Ta'ala, he has censured them and he has scolded them due to this assumption that they have had. وهذا الظن. In this speculation that they have had, لِكَوْنَهُ أَوْ لِكَوْنِهِ بَاطِلًا, because it is false and it is erroneous. Allah Ta'ala, he has sent to them due to this erroneous assumption that they have had, that they have been created for no reason. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى. Allah Ta'ala, he says, وَمَا خَلَقْنَا السَّمَاءَ وَالْأَرْضَ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا بَاطِلًا. And we have not created the heavens nor the earth. And we have not created the heavens and the earth, nor that which is between them two, erroneously, for no reason, falsely. ذَلِكَ ظَنُّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. But that is the speculation of those who disbelieve. Those who disbelieve, this is what they think. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells us, what is the end result for those who have this type of thinking? What is the end result for those who have this type of mentality, what is the reward of those who have this type of idea and ideology? Allah Ta'ala says, فَوَيْلٌ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنَ النَّارِ. So woe unto those who disbelieve from the fire. Woe unto those who disbelieve from the fire. Their reward will be the fire. The reward of those who believe that they have been put here for no reason. The reward of those who think that we have been put here for no purpose, that there is no purpose to life, that there is no purpose of being here in this dunya, that there is no purpose for their existence, then their result will be the fire. The consequence is the fire. The reward is the fire. فَوَيْلٌ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنَ النَّارِ. So woe unto those who disbelieve from the fire. For them is the fire. فَهَذَا ظَنُّ الْكَافِرِينَ. So this is the speculation of the kuffar. فَأَوْضَحَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى أَنَّهُ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ بِالْحَقِّ. So Allah Ta'ala, he has made it clear that he has created the heavens and the earth in truth. He has created the heavens and the earth with truth. لِيَعْرِفَ النَّاسُ. so that the human beings, they may know بِنَفْسِهِ وَقُدْرَتِهِ الْعَظِيمَةِ, so that they may know about Allah and that they may know about His tremendous ability. وَأَنَّهُ مُسْتَحِقُ لِلْعِبَادِ, and that Allah Ta'ala, He is the only one who deserves to be worshipped alone. Anyone who reflects upon the tremendous creation of the sun, the tremendous creation of the sky, and how it is upon us and how it is over us without any pillars, how there is no imperfections in it, there are no rifts, there are no rips or tears inside of the sky, how it serves as a canopy, how the earth is like a bed, has been spread out, so on and so forth. One who reflects upon these things, he will understand that the one who created these things, and he is tremendous, that the one who created these things, he is the Almighty. The one who created these things, he is the All-Wise. The one who created these things, La ilaha illahu, that the one who created these things, nothing has a right to be worshipped in truth except for him. He will understand beyond the shadow of a doubt, La ilaha illallah. Nothing has the right to be worshipped in truth except Allah. You understand that beyond a shadow of a doubt. Beyond a shadow of a doubt. The one who arranged these things, you understand beyond a shadow of a doubt, nothing has the right to be worshipped in truth except for Him. You understand that these things, they were not made in just, they were not put there just for no reason. But it must be a great purpose in why they were there. And that purpose is as Allah Ta'ala, He informs us in the Qur'an. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, and I did not create the jinn, nor the mankind, except for them to worship me. The jinn and the mankind have been created in order to worship Allah Azza wa Jal. Now you reflect upon all of those created things that were created by Allah Azza wa Jal, that were put in place, and that are necessary for the existence of the jinn of the mankind. And then you will realize and you will understand that everything has been created so that Allah's worship may be established. Everything has been created to establish La ilaha illallah. Could human beings be here without gravity? Could human beings be here without the sun? Could human beings be here without heat? Could human beings be here without photosynthesis? Can human beings be here without water? Can human beings be here without air? So on and so forth. Then you will realize that what? All of these things were created to establish La ilaha illallah. All of these things were created to help us to establish La ilaha illallah. All of these things were created to help us to establish the obedience to Allah, to establish the worship to Allah Azza wa Jalla. So it is a must, ya ibad. It is a must that we worship Allah and we worship Allah alone. All of these things were created to help us to worship Allah. Not so that we may utilize them to worship other than Allah. Not so that we may utilize them to be disobedient to Allah. But so that we may utilize them to worship Allah and Allah Azza wa Jalla alone. So it is incumbent upon us that we understand this and that we know Allah by His name and by His attributes, because this is that which will help us into worshiping Allah and Allah Azza wa Jalla alone. This is from that which will help us to establish the purpose for which we were created by knowing the names and the attributes of Allah Azza wa Jalla without abrogating them, without denying them, without changing their meanings, without trying to give to them a similitude, without trying to explain them, without likening them to the attributes of the human beings and so on and so forth, believing in them correctly, the way of Ahlul Sunnah was Jama'ah. This will help us and this will aid us into establishing the purpose for our creation. So it is incumbent upon us that we know the names and the attributes of Allah Azza wa Jalla, that we put great emphasis upon this, that we put great emphasis upon this, because it will help us establish the purpose on which we were created. This is from that which is what it means to be a Muslim. هذا فأقيموا الصلاة.